afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Welcome to Liturgy. Please stand and take a moment to greet those around you. Our gathering hymn is number 136. Again, we keep this solemn fast. 136.
Commanded us to listen to your beloved Son. Be pleased, we pray,
nourish us inwardly by your word, that with spiritual sight made pure, we may rejoice to behold your glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, our citizenship is in heaven, and from it we also await a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. He will change our lowly body and conform with his glorified body by the power that enables him also to bring all things into subjection to himself. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, whom I love and long for, my joy and crown, in this way stand firm to the Lord. Beloved, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Next to her heart pained.
columnist, Joan Vinacci, writes that while she and her family will continue to act safely and responsibly for the good of all, she says, I'll never want to return to driveway visits. I don't want to go back in time when I couldn't chase after this little boy and wipe his face for the joyous encounter with ice cream, or pick up his new baby brother. FaceTime has its moments, but it's not the same as pushing him on a swing or catching him at the end of a slide. She goes on to say that craving for human contact makes us human. The fear of losing it again may be the biggest hurdle when it comes to fighting the pandemic. We need people. We need people. Whatever our political beliefs or whatever phase of life we're in, we need a friend who comes over for a glass of wine. The daughter who shows up to help with a computer problem. And the grandchild who jubilantly disturb the empty nest. We need our office mates, and not just for the energy of their ideas, but for the snippets of their life outside of work that are shared while waiting in a Starbucks. As this pandemic grinds along, Joan Vinacci writes, so much divides us and pulls us apart. That's why every connection is so precious. I'm grateful, she says, for the gift of a little boy who reaches out to grab my hand and his brother touches my heart. Now as much as ever, we need to come together as family. It's just too frightening and lonely apart. The late Archbishop Desmond Tutu said that God places us in the world as God's fellow workers, agents of transfiguration. We work with God so that injustice is transfigured into justice, so that there will be more compassion and caring, so that there will be more laughter and joy, so that there will be more togetherness in God's world. The joy experienced in a two-year-old grandson's hug is such a moment of transfiguration, when the love and care we possess transfigures brokenness, isolation, and grief into trust, healing, and acceptance. As we come to appreciate all the more during these difficult days, difficult 2 years, and now as our eyes and our hearts are focused on the people of Ukraine, these simply expressions of love and care transfigures the human experience into meaning and purpose. The figure of Christ on Mount Tabor calls you and me as individuals and as a community to be what Desmond Tutu called agents of transfiguration, to take on the work of transforming the coldness, the sadness, and despair around us into the love, compassion, and hope of our God. believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. In all things made, for us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was he incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified and not his Father. He suffered death and was buried. He rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He sent into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in order to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who is spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As we're invited to the banquet table of our heavenly Lord, let's now offer our prayers and our concerns for ourselves and for our entire world.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. For the Church, that we may listen with both our minds and hearts to God's beloved Son and be transformed by his words, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a recentering of our lives during the season of Lent, that God's grace will guide us to love God more fully, to love our neighbors as we do ourselves, so that we may live forever Christ's new resurrected life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to the pandemic and the full restoration of our community, that God will protect the human family from new variants and suppress the virus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to the invasion of Ukraine, that God's divine spirit will look after and protect his people and that a peaceful resolution may be reached soon, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who need healing or peace in their lives, especially members of our parish family, that God's gracious spirit will give their bodies and minds comfort and wholeness. We especially pray for Noreen Comau, Barbara Sharno, Faye Ellis, Maggie, Paul Thibault, Kathy, Suzanne Hendricks, Nelson Family, Paul Rapido, Barbara Sikousis, Dominic Gardner, Mary Ellen, Chastity Bautista, Jeannie Clark, and all who have been impacted by abuse in any form. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, that they may be brought into the eternal peace of God's presence through Jesus, who is the resurrection and the life. For all who died this week, and special intentions after this Mass for Dolores, Dominic, and Michael Catalino, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts, and those prayers and people who are written in our book of intentions and never forgotten by God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let's ask the intercession of Mary, Mother God, and Queen of Peace, for peace in Ukraine and throughout the world. Hail Mary.
Full of grace, the Lord is with thee.
Blessed art thou amongst women,
and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Our second collection this evening will be humanitarian aid to people in Ukraine. We ask the check to be made out to St. Mary's Parish. If you do not bring your checkbook this week, next week or the week after, and just put in the memo section.
Our hymn during the preparation of gifts is number 121, led by the Spirit, number 121.
Spirit.
it is acceptable to God, our ever-loving Father. O Lord, may this sacrifice, we pray, cleanse us of our faults, and sanctify your faithful in body and mind. For the celebration of the Paschal festivities, we ask this in Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
My friends, the Lord be with you.
Yes,
lift up your hearts.
Lift up the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty eternal God, for your beloved Son. For after he told the disciples of his coming death, on the holy mountain he manifested to them his glory, to show even by the testimony of the law and the prophets that the passion leads to the glory of the resurrection. So with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, together we acclaim. In hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome. into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, the spouse, the apostles, and all the saints, who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to your life, and may praise and glorify you, your Son, Jesus Christ. Do hear me with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever.
you are truly present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to possess you within my soul. Since I am unable to, at this moment, receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually in my heart. I embrace you as being already there and unite myself only to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Our Psalm of Communion is number 665, Hosea, number 665.
Thank you.
glorious mysteries, we make thanksgiving to you, allowing us, while still here on earth, to be partakers, even now, of the things of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. We'd like to continue our celebration by joining us up the hall for pasta dinner with magic by our own Steve Charette. Our free will donations will benefit our elected charity, Stand Up For Kids, Helping Homeless Children of Worcester. We're grateful for the generosity of our friends and our school home for sponsoring this event. And we will honor our friend, the piano, for his 40 years of loving service to our parish family. We're just children back then. I've begun off my all-night is in preparation for Tuesday evening. On Tuesday evening, we will have pizza with the pastor, and I will be available to answer any questions that you have. So plan to be with us at 5:30 up in the hall. All ladies welcome. I'm hungry for pizza and answers to your faith questions. My friends, the Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Let's go forth in peace, the love and serve the Lord, one another.
Thanks be to God.
Our final hymn of praise is number 660, Change Our Hearts. Number 660.
Paradise.
Three.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.